Earth has evolved over the ages and gave life to various species. As Earth evolved, so did we, humans. But as we evolved, we became more greedier and created more chaos.
Having selected the most beautiful creature imaginable, natural grace and power in every line of its body, perfectly suited to its environment, a vision of evolutionary wonderment. Then, giving it the worst type of wasting cancer imaginable. Humanity is that disease. The failed ape has failed at everything since its appearance, and nature will take millions of years to right the damage.
Sometime back, Antarctica's temperature rose higher than usual. This led to big chunks of ice melting and joining the water. So this leads to higher sea levels, which causes tsunamis and leads to catastrophic damage to all the species.
Humans are unusual animals by any stretch of the imagination. Our special abilities, from big brains to opposable thumbs, from questioning everything in science, have allowed us to change our world dramatically and even leave the planet. There are also odd things about us, but that doesn't mean we're chaotic. I fail to understand how they make the term of beautiful species such as a human so intelligent, so creative as being chaotic and destroying the world. We humans are intelligent. We humans are the most creative species on this planet. We have been able to do so many things so many other species haven't been able to, which actually proves it. We are the most gifted beings on this planet. Everyone says that humans are kind of not very emotional, because we often have people saying that another person cannot be very humane to animals. But whatever it is, we have the ability to do it all. Humans are the best species in the world.
Along with the benefits that humans have brought with evolution, they have also caused massive damage. Humans pollute the land, air, and water with unwanted refuse. Almost 2.4 billion people don't have clean drinking water. The US alone produces about 147 metric tons of air pollution. It is difficult to find a beach that doesn't have litter. The humans produce about 300 million tons of plastic each year. More than 8 million tons of plastic is dumped in the oceans, and in 2017, almost 5 trillion pieces of plastic littered in seas. The plastic in seas has devastating effects on wildlife.
Apart from using up all our natural resources and destroying our surroundings, humans have also killed many species. According to recent studies, humankind is utterly insignificant and dominant in the grand scheme of life. The world's 7.6 billion people have caused the loss of 83% of all mammal wildlife.
Firstly, I would like to contradict Team B. She said that humans cannot be chaotic. What about the 9/11 attacks by Al-Qaeda? What about the world wars? What about all the wars we are doing? Isn't that chaotic? Now, to continue with my point, humans are nothing but monsters of death and destruction. Humans are destroying the environment and wildlife at a rapid rate. They're polluting the earth and slaughtering billions of farm animals yearly. When they're not butchering animals, they're butchering each other. Do humans sound like the best species and superior to other animals? More like a parasitic plague heading rapidly towards extinction.
We all know the Hiroshima Nagasaki incident. One atomic bomb killed 70,000 humans in 5 seconds and also killed many other species in Japan. These nuclear weapons cost so much to the environment and us. If one of these could do so much, then imagine the damage. And there are about...
I would like to rebuttal on what Team A said in round... Team A and Team C said in round one. You boys said that the humans are a very dominating species. Well, I would like to say that the human's genetic evolution is slower than all other animals, and the other animals had their time conquering the planet, and now it's our turn.
Yes, sure, indeed, no doubt. Well, talking about humans dominating, it's justified, because humans being the most intelligent, being the most creative, has to do something to this world. Just imagine like those animals with only 4 senses and 3 senses going around the world hunting animals. We humans were on the planet for a cause. We have to do something great for our planet. And now we are almost close to becoming a two-planet species. That's what even Stephen Hawking said. He said there is no future for humans without evolution.
Humans are also the cause for the extinction of various other species. If we continue to kill other innocent species, it would lead to their extinction and depletion of other organisms that depend on them, which would in turn affect the ecosystem. The main cause of all this is our human species. So how can we say that human species is the best when all we do is damage the world?
I would like to contradict Team B. You said that human beings are very intelligent and like the most intelligent species. This may be true, but without humans, if they were to go overnight, then civilization eventually would still continue and there would be a new birth of life. Also, human beings not only kill other species, they've also killed their own species. In the 20th century alone, 108 million people were killed in wars. And not only this, many people were severely injured and emotionally traumatized by these wars.
I would like to pose a question to Team B. You said that it was the animals who conquered the world before humans. But that time, they did not like kill others brutally like we humans do. But now, what we are doing right now is basically killing other creatures and killing ourselves too. Now, I would like to continue with my points. So, technology has created various impacts on the world. We humans literally drive our life with it. One such example is a mobile. Did you know that these phones release various radiations? These towers and cell phones release harmful radiation, causing birds severe brain problems. And these took out the lives of many birds.
Now, let's look at the facts. We're not the most numerous. Bacteria win. We're not the strongest. Elephants win. Not the fastest. Cheetahs win. But we surely are best at one thing, at being selfish and greedy.
In my answer to Team A, well, we haven't always been talking about animals' domination. We've seen the Ice Age. We've seen dinosaurs, haven't we? Or you can just go check out Jurassic Park if we haven't. Well, on the serious note, we humans have gone something called behavioral modernity, which means we consider everything, our creation, our inventions, we create something, everything as part of humans. We have developed so many things, so many that not any other animal on this earth has developed. Speech, language, consciousness, tool use, art, music, material, culture, commerce, agriculture. We are the most dynamic species in the world. Over to my teammate.
Stories of greed, ego, and selfishness of humans bombard us, but a study shows that humans are inherently good. A study by the Common Cause Foundation reveals two transformative findings. The first is that a large number of the 1,000 people...
We are destroying our ecosystem not only by killing off other species at alarming rates, but also threatening our very own existence. We are recklessly biting off the hand that feeds us. Human beings are the most selfish species in the world. We take advantage of the resources provided to us by nature and misuse them. This would leave us with nothing in the end, killing us all.
Team B, you said that humans are, like, they create a lot of things, but as well with all of the creations that they have made, they've also destroyed countless numbers of things. A lot of other creatures' habitats have been destroyed by humans, and a lot of our own buildings, people, everything has been destroyed by ourselves as well. The smallest pain in our little finger gives us more concern than the destruction of millions of our fellow beings. This is a quote by William Hazard.
Due to all of this mention above, the world will take an unexpected turn. There will be ozone holes leading to diseases, pollution leading to death, extinction of species due to no balance on the life cycle will make our graveyard. After all, humans are the best species in the world. I don't think we humans are not only destroying ourselves, but also others.
The human race is the only species on this planet that's deliberately destroying their own environment and bringing all other species to further their own interests. The human race as a whole, I say, is selfish.
And I would like to conclude by saying that Earth satisfies every man's need, but not every man's greed. So I finally conclude by saying that human beings are not the best species in the world, and I rest my case. Thank you.
Stories of greed and ego bombard us, but a study shows that humans are inherently good. If you don't believe me, there was a study published by The Guardian 4 whole years ago. A study by the Common Cause Foundation reveals that 2 transformative findings. One, the first is that the large majority of the 1,000 people they surveyed, 74% identifies more strongly with unselfish values than selfish values. This means that they are more interested in helpfulness, honesty, forgiveness, and justice than in money, fame, status, and power. The second is that the similar majority, 78%, believes to be more selfish than they really are. In the other words, they may have made a terrible mistake about how other people think about themselves. These findings suggest that people are inherently nice. Then, another study posted by the journal Frontiers Psychology points out that the behavior of chimpanzees are more selfish. I would like to rest my
from the Stone Age to now, the cycle of evolution has rendered humans as the most evolved of all species. Or so we think. We have destroyed wildlife, killed animals, brought an entire species to an extinction, and rendered poor, voiceless animals at the receiving end of brutal torture. Our water bodies can no longer flow due to the waste it has accumulated, and global warming has resulted in a rise of ocean temperature that is destroying the 25 million year old great coral reef. But do we stop? Hardly.
Human beings have made so many laws and regulations, yet they continue to be disregarded, and dangerous criminals roam free. Human beings can't even control and restrain their own species from committing crimes that destroy their own themselves, other species, and harm buildings and things around them. How can they be considered a trustworthy species, let alone the best?